Good morning. Welcome to St. Juan Diego Catholic Church. To properly celebrate the resurrection of our Lord, please take this time to turn off and put away all your electronic devices. Today is Good Shepherd Sunday. The shepherd gives all to protect his flock. As we begin to worship the Father in our buildings, we recall that we share one faith, one baptism, one bread, and the one shepherd who guides us. As the psalmist said, we are his people, the sheep of his flock. The merciful love of the Lord fills the earth. By the word of the Lord, the heavens were made. Alleluia. Our celebrant today for this Mass is Father Dan, along with Father John, and assisted by Deacon Doug and Deacon Bruce.
Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My sisters, my brothers, what a great and glorious day we have. What a great and glorious God we have that has blessed us so richly and allowed us to be in this place. Let's just give God a hand for the wonderful things he has done. When we prepare and get our hearts ready, we get our bodies ready, we get our souls ready to celebrate these holy mysteries, let us pause and ask the Lord to bless us and remind us of the baptism that we received when we were first baptized, when we first received the grace of baptism, and let us renew that baptism in each of us. Dear brothers and sisters, we humbly beseech our Lord and God to bless this water he has created, which will be sprinkled on us as a memorial of our baptism. May he help us by his grace to remain faithful to the Spirit we have received. Almighty Lord and God, you are the source and origin of all life. Whether of body or soul, we ask you to bless this water, which we use in confidence to implore forgiveness of our sins, and to obtain the protection of your grace against all illness and every snare of the enemy. Grant, O Lord, in your mercy, that living waters may always spring up for our salvation, and that we may approach you with a pure heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Jesus is risen, sing
us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, lead us to share in the joys of heaven, so that the humble flock may reach where the brave shepherd has gone before, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. You be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice and proclaimed, "Let the whole house of Israel know for certain that God has made both Lord and Christ, this Jesus whom you have crucified." Now when they heard this, they were cut to the heart, and they asked Peter and the other apostles, "What are we to do, brothers?" Peter said to them, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is made to you and to your children and to all those far off, whomever the Lord will call." He testified with many other arguments and was exhorting them, "Save yourselves from this corrupt generation." Those who accepted his message were baptized, and about 3,000 persons were added that day. The word of the Lord.
Shepherd, I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want.
When the day is long and temptation strong, and the cords of death encompass me, I cry out in need of deliverance. You take my hand and give me
shepherd.
the sparrow. At my side, you give me strength. The Lord is my shepherd.
Reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, if you are patient when you suffer for doing what is good, this is a grace before God. For to this you have been called, because Christ also suffered for you, leaving you an example that you should follow in his footsteps. He committed no sin, and no deceit was found in his mouth. When he was insulted, he returned no insult. When he suffered, he did not threaten. Instead, he handed himself over to the one who judges justly. He himself bore our sins in his body upon the cross, so that, free from sin, we might live for righteousness. By his wounds, you have been healed. For you had gone astray like sheep, but you have now returned to the shepherd and guardian of your souls. The word of the Lord.
The word of God was from the start. The word drove land and sea apart. It's dangerous and sharp, don't let it fool ya. The word raised up and brought down kings. The word made rocks and living things. And all creation sings a
The Lord be with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said, "Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever does not enter a sheepfold through the gate, but climbs over elsewhere, is a thief and a robber. But whoever enters through the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens it for him, and the sheep hear his voice as the shepherd calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has driven out all his own, he walks ahead of them, and the sheep follow him because they recognize his voice. But they will not follow a stranger. They will run away from him because they do not recognize the voice of strangers. Although Jesus used this figure of speech, the Pharisees did not realize what he was trying to tell them. So Jesus said again, "Amen, amen, I say to you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved and will come and go out and find pasture. A thief comes only to steal and slaughter and destroy. I came so that they might have life and have it more abundantly." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So I'm wondering if anybody is here from the Chase Building Team. Is anybody here? Anybody here from Chase Building Team? Alan, are you here?
2, 3, 4.
Okay, come on up, Alan. He was the project manager, and I just want to give him a. So I just want to give you something back. I don't need it anymore, okay? I think I can give it away now. You can have it back, Alan. So for the last year, every Tuesday morning, I've met at this site and had to wear one of those and a little hard hat every Tuesday morning, and I'm just glad that I don't have to worry about putting on an orange vest when I have to come in here anymore. Today we celebrate Good Shepherd Sunday. Good Shepherd Sunday, and I was so struck by picking Good Shepherd Sunday. I didn't look at the calendar and say, "Oh good, it's Good Shepherd Sunday, we'll open the church on Good Shepherd Sunday." I said, "We're opening the church on May 7th because on May 8th I'm getting on a plane for Italy and I want that church to be done." And of course, when I told the crew at Chase Building Team that May 7th, we were having our first Mass, their eyes got really big and said, "What? May 7th? That sounds so soon." But we obviously are here, and although we're not quite done yet, you can see there are several details we need. We still need a crucifix. Jesus is still on his way. He's just being finished. The carving is done, but the shipping hasn't happened. We did get our altar and our ambo. These are the permanent altar and ambo. I hope you like them. They're lovely. But I have to make a trip when I get back from Italy to go pick up the altar, the crucifix and the presider's chair and some candlesticks. And we still have quite a few pieces of art coming to be able to finish the church. And we still have Stations of the Cross. If you notice these little white, I'll give you a little bit of instructions on the church, okay? All the stained glass is in the main body of the church, and it's lovely. But we are gonna also have Station of the Cross. If you see these little white circles on the walls, they're not fire extinguishers or sprinklers, they are light fixtures for when we put in the 14 Stations of the Cross surrounding each of the north and the south transepts. So please pray for the carver. He's been working really hard to He's got five of the stations of the cross done, and he still has nine to carve. So please pray for him in his carving endeavors. He says about 90% of his days and nights are spent carving and building things, and obviously he's done a beautiful job. We are the flock of Christ. I can say I'm the shepherd, but ultimately the shepherd of our souls is Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is why this church is built. Jesus Christ is who gathers us together in his name. Jesus Christ is the source of life. Jesus Christ is the fountain and the rock of our salvation. Jesus Christ is our good shepherd. And in such a beautiful way, he's allowed me, I think that the reading today is so fitting, especially as we hear of the trials and tribulations that we're going to face. You know, I can honestly say that I've had a few trials and tribulations. I'm not looking at the building team right now when I say that. I've had some trials and tribulations on this journey. But I want to ask a few things of you, and I'll promise a few things of you. First, I want to find out if your family was here for the first Mass or the first year of Masses at St. Juan Diego, go ahead and stand up. If you were here for the first year of Masses at St. Juan Diego, go ahead and stand up. Yeah, we've also added to those families' numbers. You know, there's a lot of kids that aren't old enough to remember the first Mass because they weren't born yet. But what a blessing it is. Okay, now I'm going to test the other end of that. Obviously, all of you have joined the parish. If you've joined the parish in the last 6 months, go ahead and stand. Go ahead and stand. If you've joined the parish, if you started coming here in the last 6 months, go ahead and stand. Amen. So all the rest of you, you're all in between, right? Well, amazingly, 12 years ago, this Christmas it will be 12 years, on November 28th, 2004, the first Mass at Navarette Grade School happened. That was some 12 years ago, the first Mass happened. And about 5 or 6 months later, it was May of 2005, I get this call from the bishop and the diocesan placement team, and they said, we're gonna send you to St. Mary's in Chandler. And I thought, oh, that's nice. And I looked at the balance sheet. You know, as a pastor, you always look at the balance sheet. I looked at how many people are in the parish, and over 4,000 families were in the parish. And I looked and I said, oh, they have 9 Masses. Oh, good. And then I met with Father Rob Clements, and he drove me around the site. He drove me around the parish. He drove me to the limits of the parish. It took a while, I'll tell you. He drove me all the way down to Navarette Grade School, and he said, see this school? He said, we have Mass there every Sunday. He said, but you have to build a church for these people. You had to build a church for all the people that live in South Chandler. And I said, oh, that's nice. I said, they didn't tell me that when they asked me to take on this parish. And then he said, well, we're going to drive around and we're going to show you the new land. And he showed me the land. And of course, it was this lovely 10-acre piece of dirt. No development, no sidewalks, no streets, no development around it. It was just farmland. And of course, I had to kind of squint my eyes and turn my head sideways and go, okay, I guess we can build on this site. I guess we can build a church here. And then, of course, I started realizing and calculating how much it was going to cost. You know, the first calculations are so wonderful. Oh, it's going to be about $4 million. Oh, that's nice. You know, I come from a family of 10. You know, I come from a very humble family. You know, we had a little house in Northwest Phoenix, and we paid the rent, we paid the mortgage most months, and we scrimped and we saved, and we're a happy little family. You know, I say little, being very clear, we were a Catholic family, you know, just the 10 of us. But we never had a whole lot, you know, so when I looked at the price and I said, $4 million, I thought, okay, Lord, you're going to have to help me out here. And then, of course, 11 years goes by, and the prices go up a little bit, right? So we finally settled on a price, and we decided that $7.2 million was just enough, right? Well, let me tell you, you can look around. I've never built my own home. Hopefully you've had that privilege and that opportunity of building your own house. Well, I can say I finally built a house. And I hope you like it. What a blessing it has been, this journey. The great thing is the journey's not over. The great thing, the journey is just begun. You know, we have about 900 and there's about 930 seats right now. You look around you, there's about 930 people sitting down. I say sitting down because there's about 50 or 70 people still standing up. What a great blessing. Now, one of the nice things about this church is it's expandable. See that wall back there? We can take that wall down and we can move it back about 40 feet. And we can gain back some space and maybe even build a second, maybe we can build a second level. What a great thing it is. What a great thing it is that we can build a house that fits our community, that fits our family. And I say our family because this is family. You know, I've been here for 12 years, and this is family. We are the family. We are the sheep of his flock. And when the Lord calls us and challenges us and lifts us up to himself, we know it is the Lord who is here in our midst. It is the Lord who loves us and shapes us. The Lord who feeds us and gives us strength. The Lord who blesses us and gives us all manner of good things. Now, hopefully, in the next few weeks, you'll take some more time to kind of look at all the details. You know, this morning's kind of rushed. We kind of go through all the masses and everybody gets to see the new church. But hopefully you take some time. You know, we'll have people on site most mornings to be able to come in and see the church and spend some time praying here, spend some time offering your heart to God in this place, and may God continue to richly bless us at St. Mary's and St. Juan Diego community, and may God bless us all. Amen. We now join together and make our common profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. Forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The good shepherd does not allow the sheep to wander in harm's way. Knowing that we are heard, let us pray with confidence.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, our bishops, and all entrusted with the care of the Lord's flock, that they may fill the role of shepherd and protect the people of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the example of the Good Shepherd to inspire the leaders of the city, the state, and the nation to serve the feeble, the destitute, and the most vulnerable, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For young men and women, that God may give them the gift of understanding to discern their service to the church, and for the gift of courage to follow his call, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all in our parish who have been washed clean in the waters of baptism, may their lives be changed by the power of the risen Christ, and may they be open to the fullness of his life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those of us gathered here today, that we may always seek to deepen our relationships with the risen Savior and be open to the voice of God in our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish community, may we go forth from our church buildings to share our faith and build the kingdom of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, that the knowledge of the resurrection may give them strength and hope, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those prayers in our parish book of intercession and the prayers that we offer to God in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the faithfully departed, especially the benefactors of this church who have gone before us, including Michael and Dolores Dugan, that Jesus, the Lamb, will shepherd them and lead them to eternal life with the Father, and for the people of the parish for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Merciful Father, you know us each by name. Hear our prayers and let your Holy Spirit fill our hearts. We ask this in the name of your loving shepherd, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. Be seated.
My shepherd, and how I love you. You are the only way for me. You are my shepherd, so I will follow. You only want what's right for me. Thank you.
shepherd, whom I have followed. To safe waters you lead me. You give me courage and strength within me. You guide me on the path to thee. Your name forever glory be. Even though I walk through the darkness, I will fear no harm. Even though I walk through the valley, I will fear no harm, for you are at my side.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in the paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy. Through Christ our Lord. Okay, so this will be the first time I really get to sing out, so I want to make sure that you respond loud and clear, okay? The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously. When Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, he never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrifice who dies no more, the Lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna.
let's practice putting those kneelers down. Wonderful. I also want to take a moment and just glory in the fact that we have kneelers. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Thomas our Bishop, Eduardo his assistant, all the clergy, and all who serve your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with Saint Juan Diego, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
As a family, and at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to sing.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours forever. Amen. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
I don't know where I'm going. The road ahead is hard to see. I cannot know for certain where you're leading me. My own heart is a mystery, and I'm unsure of your will. Though my desire to please you surely pleases still, your voice warms winter's chill. Follow me.
tables made of marble, there were tables made of wood, tables made of plastic, glass, or stone. Each table is an altar where we kneel to meet our need, to know in truth we never are alone. At this table we come to know the mystery. In every age and every time in history, how blessed we are to be called to this table. How blessed we are by this sacred banquet spread. Of your fullness we receive, in your presence we believe. More than wine, more than symbol, more than bread. How blessed we are, by Jesus we are fed at this table. At this table. At this table we're connected to our loved ones far away, for those who wait for us beyond the sky, where the feast goes on forever and the welcome never ends, and love is the only reason why. The host of heaven satisfies your yearning. Our eyes are open, hearts within us burning. How blessed we are to be called to this table. How blessed we are by the sacred banquet spread. Of your fullness we receive, in your presence we believe. More than wine, more than symbol, more than bread. How blessed we are, by Jesus we are fed at this table. At this table. Of hunger in our hearts revealed. Just say the word and we are healed. A gift, a treasure beyond words. This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence living in me. This
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me, and I'm desperate for you.
Let us pray. Look upon your flock, little kind shepherd, and be pleased to settle in eternal pastures the sheep you have redeemed by the precious blood of your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Please be seated for just a moment. I know Mass is running a little bit late today, but such is life. As we say, when we build a new church, we don't know how long the first Mass is going to take, right? I want to say a few thank yous to some people before I send you forth, and we have a few announcements. You'll notice at the doors there will be school children from St. Mary Bashek School, and they'll be outside after Mass to give you some information on how we still have lots of scholarships available for the school for the coming year. So make sure that you come and talk to one of the kids about how wonderful our school is. Our registration for catechism, for our fall catechism program, is happening in the next couple of weeks. There will be on the 23rd and the 25th. The 25th is for new families. Note that registration forms for our summer Bible school, our vacation Bible school, is coming up in a couple weeks. And there is obviously a correction. Our Sunday Mass at 12:30 is moved to 1 o'clock. We have an 11:30 in Spanish here, but the 1 o'clock Mass is at 1 o'clock. It's not at 12:30 anymore. We've had to move it a little later because of the Spanish Mass. I want to say thank you to a couple of different people who have helped build this place. Phoenix Design Group and David Arambula is our architect. He did a beautiful job. Thank you. Now, I'll just name off a couple of different groups and people who have worked on it. Venetian Plaster did all the outside stucco, and they did the Venetian plaster at the different apses and behind the cross. All of the wonderful work has been done on several different groups: JBJ Electric, Arizona Tile, APL Security, Stuhl Masonry, and Design Drywall have all done beautiful work. If you did any work on the church, if you were physically on this job site constructing the church, go ahead and stand. I know we have several people who are here who worked on the job site. Go ahead and stand if you worked on the job site. Okay, now the last thing is, we need lots of choir members, we need lectors and hospitality and Eucharistic ministers and all the different ministries, right? We need lots of different ministries to help out. We need people to sing in the choir and do all the wonderful things. You can see we have a few people that came today, so I suspect we're going to have a real blessing of riches of wonderful new families in our community, and thank you so much for coming today. Last but not least, just a thank you to you who helped get us to this place, to help contribute to build this church. You know, we got a long way to go to pay off the debt, but we certainly have gotten to the point where we built, and we're so glad that we are here in our new space. And let's give God the glory and give him a wonderful thank you and round of applause for such a blessing. Please stand. Okay, last but not least, you don't have to take down the chairs, okay? Yay! The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God, alleluia, alleluia.
and when